spirits. And I praise God for young people that love to praise the Lord and they really have a passion for God. So God bless you all for that.
Amen.
At this time, I am very grateful and thankful to Bethel SDA Church for inviting me to come out all the way from Philadelphia. I want to thank my mother and my adopted sister, Samantha, who came along with us for this opportunity to speak to you today. So I'd like to thank my mom for being with us. But most of all, I want to thank you for inviting me. I thank the Pathfinder leader, Molly, and Patty, the youth director. I thank you so much for having me. But I pray that the message that God has for you today will make you feel blessed and that you will leave here different than the way that you came. So, muy padre, fue yo. Muy padre, young blessed woman. So, yo si pasé a saber, ma fessa un capa, 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 un capa. Said, are you suited for victory? Est-ce que vous préparez pour victoire? Okay? So, avant que vous commencez, je vais vous demander de penser pour que vous vous avec nous pour vous faire un comprendre et pour vous faire comprendre. Papa, nous venons de la nous remercier pour tout ça que vous faites pour nous. Nous avons tout droit et honneur que vous serez mérité. Dans le moment, ça vous demande de Saint-Esprit à descendre pour prendre contrôle pour chouin et pour vous faire pour vous dire. Amen.
Amen.
All right. So, growing up, a lot of us have heard of the story of Joshua and the Battle of Jericho. Pathfinders, you know Joshua, don't you? You want to show us, right? And Joshua wasn't a specific battle because he had to conquer and possess the land that God had for his people, where the walls came tumbling down. And as a child, this story was so fascinating to me because all the people did was shout at the right time and the walls fell down. So, NFPT, histoire ça que réellement bizarre pour moi, pour ça ça pour yo fait, son coup de cri yo fait et puis tout miraille yo tombé. Tout d'un coup, son bagay impossible, right? And Israel invaded Jericho and possessed the land that God promised them for the past 40 years. However, in studying Joshua 4, chapter 4 to chapter 7, I noticed the victory was not as simple for the people of Israel as I thought it was. Victoire, ça que yo le recevoir, c'est pas un victoire qui est simple. Et je dis à nous pas parler sur ça. Today, a lot of you will be anticipating victory through this opening ceremony. We look forward to investing and moving forward in your ranks or your classes, and it will take a lot of hard work to get through this year. In faith in Jesus' name, I praise God for the upcoming investiture that every single one of you will partake in. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. All right, so on this Sabbath day, as you think of the many things that you have gone through to make it to this day, I want to take the time to allow us to reflect on what is necessary to have victory in life. Non, ça va, ça. Moi, je vais même pour nous réfléchir, pour nous penser, qui ça que nous besoin pour nous réaliser victoire dans la vie. Let's be real with ourselves, apart from pathfinders and coming to church every Saturday. We go through battles daily. Does everybody go through a battle every day? Si ça va, bataille, qu'on a passé chaque jour, nous avons bataille, qu'on a fait, nous non bataille. There are certain battles as we go through in life, such as loss of jobs or sickness, maybe betrayal or heartache, or maybe a test that you have to take, a final, an exam. There's difficulties that come, and these are your battles that you go through. In addition to these things, we are in a battle with the enemy, who wants to rob us of our salvation. Nous non bataille, pas seulement avec l'argent, avec job, avec difficulté, mais nous non bataille que nous a passé avec ennemis, qui t'a aimé nous, qui t'a aimé que nous perdu, right? And so in these moments, we have to remember that Jesus has died so that we might have eternal life. This makes the devil mad, and he will do anything it takes to rob us of the opportunity to live with Jesus forever. My question to you all today is, will you let the devil steal all that the Lord has in store for you? Que si yo me guía por lo matéo, si es que la quité Satan, volé, tout ça que bon Dieu gagne en préparation pour vous, tout ça que bon Dieu gagne pour en réserve, est-ce que la quité Satan plenie la même? No, I would hope not. Will you allow the devil to win? You may be thinking, of course not. But Jesus said in John chapter 14:2-4, in my Father's house, let me give you guys a second to get there. I'm kind of fast. Sorry. All right. So John 14:2-4, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know. So it's enough for y'all to touch yourself as best as I can. Jésus dit que il dit n'a pas pour mal préparer en place pour nous, right? So bon Dieu dit Jésus dit il va préparer en place pour nous. Mais victoire qu'on a parlé à, victoire qu'on a pensé à, victoire qu'on a cherché chaque jour, mais victoire. C'est en place que bon Dieu a préparé pour nous maintenant, pour nous. And he dit que il va venir encore et la prochaine voir à lui-même et côté lié nous avec lui. And let tout côté que lui allait nous voir avec lui. Et chemin pour aller la montrer nous chemin pour aller. Do you see that? Jesus is saying, I am setting up a place for you to be with me. He is creating an atmosphere for us to spend consistent quality time with him. How do you guys feel now when you pray and you close your eyes? Can you see Jesus while you're praying? Can you see him face to face? But don't you want to have that moment where you get to touch Jesus, where you get to hold him, when you get to hug him, when you get to play with him? And that's what he wants us to have. And this is what the victory looks like. Jesus is in heaven setting up our new home with him. And this is his promise. Hebrews 6 verse 18 tells us it is impossible for God to lie. So Jesus lui fait une promesse et Hébreux 6 verset 18 dit que c'est impossible pour mon Dieu mentir. Est-ce que nous pouvons être déçus et dire que Jésus n'a pas délivré? Non, faut nous gagner espoir que Jésus va tomber. So if God has our place of victory set up already, we need to prepare ourselves for this. Before people get married, they prepare, right? Before we give birth to a child, we prepare, right? Before we have a victory in battle, we must prepare. Let's go to Maya. Est-ce que nous just tout d'un coup, just renomone pour Maya? Est-ce que là, on va accoucher? Est-ce que vous just prépare Maya ou just fait petit là? Non, on prépare parce que vous gagnez en victoire que vous va recevoir, right? And so you may ask, how do we make it down here? Well, if we keep reading in John chapter 14, come up and join victoire. Come up and join. Read John chapter 14, verse 5. But right here, yonan disciple fille de Thomas, c'est lui-même qui a parlé. Thomas, the disciple, asked the same thing. Lord, we do not know where you are going, and how can we know the way? How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So, là, Thomas, joint réponse là. Demandez, comment vous joint Jean pour recevoir victoire ça? And the victory is found in Jesus. And Jesus said, je suis le, and la vérité, et la vie. And Joshua was a great example to someone who had a relationship with God. He was suited for victory. Josué était déjà préparé pour victoire. And I want to share with you three things you and I will need to have access to victory. Moi, je vais vous partager avec nous trois bagages que nous avons besoin pour nous capables de recevoir la victoire. The first thing, Joshua understood that he needed God. Josué était gagnant, il était comprenant que les besoins de Dieu. Il n'est pas juste. Savvy wanted, he connect the person wanted, right? And this is how we receive, this is how he received instruction. This was the way. So we just read that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. So the first one is what?
The way.
Pathfinders? Jesus is the way. So this was the way. As a Pathfinder or a Christian, are you okay with receiving commands from those that are above you? Est-ce que comme chrétien, est-ce que nous avons un problème là on qui a une plus haute position or maybe on qui est plus grand parce que est-ce que vous avez difficulté comme command na mayo? No, okay, that's great. And for 40 years plus, Joshua was a servant to Moses. Right? And so he did everything without complaining. Joseph fait tout bagage sans y pas complainer. Et il pas questionner rien. Joshua trusted God to do the impossible because he saw God do great things. He saw God deliver the Israelites from slavery and split the Red Sea. Now that he has taken the place of Moses, he is ready to lead because he has seen firsthand how to lead. So Josué était comment pour lui prendre place Moïse parce qu'il était passé temps avec Yes. Il fait 40 ans, l'a suivi Moïse, l'a regardé tout jeune, l'a acheté point instruction dans même Moïse. And he spent so much time with Moses, he began to lead and he began to look like Moses. So plus quand il passait avec Moïse, il commence à sembler avec Moïse. Just like we resemble Christ when we spend more time with him. So, si nous voulons connaître the way, si nous voulons connaître comment, qui direction, qui route pour aller dans la place que Jésus préparé pour nous, faut nous, qui ça pour nous faire? Passer temps avec Jésus. So, we need to spend time with Jesus so that we know the way. In Joshua 6, 3 to 6, Josué 3 à 6, Jésus te bail instruction à Josué. Comment pour yo, what's the word? Comment pour yo joindre victoire? Li bail instruction. Si, okay, qui, so pendant nous dans histoire ça, ou est que combien de fois yo te marché au monde Jéricho?
7 fois.
Si yo te marché 10 fois, est-ce que yo t'a joindre victoire? Si on te marche 4 fois, est-ce que t'as joué une victoire? So, est-ce que nous voyons important pour nous payer attention à instruction? So, if we want to know the way to victory, we have to make sure we pay attention to the instructions that God has for our lives.
Amen.
The instructions continue down to verse 10. You can read that on your own time. But understand that our obedience to God's distinct and direct instructions are what lead us to victory. We must not allow anything or anyone cause us to do anything different than God's original plan. You may be wondering, how do I hear God's voice? My answer to you is to read God's word. Open your Bible and spend time reading the Bible. And after you do that, pray. And after you pray, have quiet time and allow God to speak back to you. Because you want to have a conversation with God. Là, prier, c'est une conversation à faire avec mon Dieu. Et parce que c'est pas tout seul qui peut parler. Vos bails pour Dieu, tu peux parler à vous. Number two, the second way that I want you guys to think about, how do we get victory? Number two is we must believe in the truth of Jesus Christ. Number two is the truth. The truth is la vérité. Joshua was someone who believed in the truth given to him by God. Joseph était quoi? Tout ça, bon Dieu dit, lui, il était quoi? L'un était attaqué, il t'a mal fait espion pour la loi, si il a gagné victoire, et il était ouais, géant, il dit, tout le monde dit non, nous pas gagné, nous ça trop fort pour nous. Mais Josué, ouais, il dit non, bon Dieu, pas gagné, qui est possible pour lui, n'a pas gagné victoire ça. And it's the same way we need to be like Joshua and believe when God says something to us. We know and believe in someone when we have a close relationship with them. And the Lord revealed himself to Joshua. And you can turn to Joshua 5:13-15. Here, Joshua has experience that dares not make him doubt that God is with him. It is after this encounter that the Lord speaks the truth to Joshua. And we can turn there really quick. Josué 5, please, I can. And I'm finally on my left. And it came to pass when Joshua was by Jericho that he lifted his eyes and looked. And behold, a man stood opposite him with his sword drawn in his hand. And Joshua went to him and said to him, "Are you for us or are you our adversaries?" So he said, "No, but as commander of the army of the Lord, I have now come." And Joshua fell on his face to the earth and worshiped, and said to him, "What does my Lord say to his servant?" Then the commander of the Lord's army said to Joshua, "Take your sandal off your foot, for the place where you stand is holy." And Joshua did so. And so, si on a présence, bon Dieu, est-ce qu'on va douter que on va gagner en victoire? No. So, si nous, c'est ça fait l'important pour nous passer plus de temps avec bon Dieu, parce que depuis nous en présence, si, pas gagner rien cap impossible dans ma vie. And so, if we continue, Joshua 6 verse 2, we see that the Lord said to Joshua, "See, I have given Jericho into your hands, its king and the mighty man of valor." Now, continue the conversation bon Dieu a fait avec Josué. Bon Dieu dit Josué, si, dis-y, ouais, dis-y, gardez. Ouvre les yeux. Avant que vous parlez de bataille, vous déjà gagné. Dis-y que ma part où j'ai contre la main, ma part où roi, et ma part où tout le monde qui a bataillé qui est puissant. So, dis déjà parlé tout ça. Et c'est même chose si nous avons besoin. Si nous déjà avons besoin, nous avons besoin de demander bon Dieu pour lui. Bon Dieu a dit nous garder ou déjà gagner. And so you have to believe that God is already providing for you. And so we have to be able to believe God. We have to be able to, do you believe when he says what he says concerning your life? Can you see? Can you see what God is saying to you? Do you have a vision from God concerning your life, and can you see yourself in heaven, living in eternity with him? C'est pas seulement ouais pour vision que bon Dieu gagne, mais est-ce qu'on a ouais tête ou à vivre dans ce ciel-là avec? Number three, finally, Jesus is the life. So Jesus is the what? The life. And without Jesus, there is no life. Nous connaissons that says, sans Jésus, je ne peux vivre. It's true. Sans Jésus, est-ce que nous yon bagay? Are we something without God? No, we need God for anything, and we're nothing without him. Without accepting him, we cannot inherit eternal life. We are nothing without Jesus. And we can go to John 11, verse 1, which says, "In him was life, and the life was the light of men." And in John 11:25, Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me shall never die." Do you believe this today? Do you believe that Jesus is the resurrection? So if something has died in your life, if something has is no longer existing, maybe you no longer have something that you need, God is the resurrection and he is the life. Anything that you need, Jesus will resurrect that thing. Prior to any battle, the Lord always gave gave Joshua the instruction for the people to sanctify themselves. You can find this in Joshua 3, verse 5, and Joshua 7, verse 13. The command was to sanctify yourselves. As Jesus came to die on the cross, we no longer have to physically sanctify ourselves through an ordinance. However, we take hold of sanctification without having Jesus in our lives. We cannot. The sanctification process within us is taking place after we have allowed Jesus to come and lead us and give us truth. Sanctification, comme on sait, le mouvement est Jésus dans la vie. When he lives within us, let us choose. When we choose to believe that Jesus is the way, help me say it, the way, the truth, and the life. When we know that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, there's going to be ways that you're going to be walking, and it's going to be difficult. And you're not going to know which way to turn. But if you turn to Jesus and you say, Jesus, help me, Jesus will help you go through the way. And when sometimes you're in circumstances, when you feel like, I don't feel good enough, I'm not perfect, I'm not pretty, I don't feel this, I'm not smart enough, I don't have the intelligence. These are lies that the enemy says to you in your mind. The enemy will lie to you.
Thank you.
God tells us to do to get the victory. So in our lives, are we watching things that leads us to destruction? What TV shows are we watching? What music are we listening to? What friends are we surrounding ourselves around? These things, if they're not from God, can be like aching. These things will cause us to miss out on God's promises, and most importantly, victory. The aches have the power to kill. Think of what it is that's causing us to miss out on heaven. No, nothing is worth us losing heaven. Is it really worth it? Do like Joshua did, because when Joshua found out that Achan was disobeying the people, do you know what he did? He got rid of Achan so fast. He got him out of the camp and he died. Achan died. They stoned him. And so I'm not telling you to go kill anybody, but what I'm telling you to do is you have to take the things out of your life that's keeping you from God. Anything that keeps you from God, let go of it, because it's not worth it. We know that Jesus is the answer. So before we close, help me remember again, how do we get to heaven? How do we get victory? How are we suited up for victory? We need one, what is it? Jesus is the
truth
and the
life.
All right. And so pathfinders, if we want to be suited, we need the way. And the life to receive victory in this life, and the life we look to receive in heaven. Won't you accept Jesus Christ into your life today? Will you accept Jesus into your life today?
Yes.
Amen. All right, so I'm going to, if anyone wants to stand up and pray, I'm going to pray with you. Yeah, sure, you can pray. We can pray. And I'm going to pray for you that God will be able to use us. And he will be our way, and he will be our truth, and he will be our life. So if you want to stand with us today and pray for this, please do so. Si vous avez prié, vous consacrez tête à Jésus, vous dites, je dis à moi, je vais recevoir victoire, je vais recevoir le chemin et la vie. So much for this word. We thank you for being with us this day. Lord, we read today that we can have the victory, that we can have the victory, and most importantly, that we can see the victory. And so, God, we're asking at this very moment that you would help us to go into the way, that you would help us to go into the truth, that you would help us to walk into the light. Father, anything at this very moment that is stopping your children from receiving the kingdom of God, which is receiving you because you are the kingdom. Father, at this very moment, I'm asking that you would help us, oh God, that you would remove, that you would block, that you would deliver, that you would break down walls. Anything that is keeping us from you, Jesus Christ, we ask that you would take them away, oh God, and help us to continue to fight the battle, that we would be like Joshua and say, yes, we have won the victory and we have the victory. We pray all these things. In Jesus Christ's name we pray.